Assalamualaikum. We continue with our lecture in Minimax. So, for the continuation, we will learn about the concept of alpha beta pruning. So, what is alpha beta pruning? So, alpha beta pruning is a process of pruning the tree. So, we cut off a certain branch of the tree, which may not have impact on the final answer. Maksudnya bila kita potong pun tree ni dia tak ada impact lah pada jawapan akhir. Because we've implemented a look ahead. Okay, look ahead. So the computer implemented a look ahead algorithm where we can predict what number that will come next in the minimax. So why we use pruning? So pruning can help to minimize the time taken to evaluate the move and to better optimize the prediction of opponent movement. So by using pruning, we can better predict the opponent movement. So kita boleh predict dengan lebih cepat lah, with faster. We can get faster result. So let's say that we have a basic minimax tree which leads to the win of maximum. Okay, sekejap. So, forgive the technical difficulties. Let's continue back. So, this is the basis of alpha beta pruning. So, in the basis of alpha beta pruning, we have a basic of minimax tree, which leads to the win of max. Okay, which leads to the win for max. So here we have max, min, max. So in left to right alpha beta pruning, we have to look from this part. Okay, sebelah ni kita tutup dengan kertas. Okay, we cover this with your hand or your a piece of paper. So instead of all numbers, you will only see two numbers on the very left side of the note. So 6 and 5. So what will be carried over at D? So because this is a max turn, you will select the highest number, which is 6. Okay. In this move, okay, you may not know what E will be. Okay. Kita tak tahu note E ni ada apa sebab kita tutup benda ni dengan kertas. Okay, you cover this with a piece of paper. But you will know that the mean may not exceed 6. Kita tahu kata dekat bahagian mean ni, we know that the mean cannot exceed 6. Dia tak boleh lebih daripada 6. Okay, macam ni kita tahu sebab contohnya between D and E we have 6 and 3. So yang naik kat atas mestilah 3 kan, 6 and 3. And then if 6 and 10, okay, E ni jawapan dia ada 10. So yang jadi duduk dekat B ni adalah 6. So it means that in the minimum part, it cannot exceed 6. Okay, macam mana pun jawapan dekat B ni tak boleh lepas daripada 6. Okay, cannot exceed 6. And then automatically you will also know that, okay, if you start to read on E, okay, J, you know that the note over here cannot also, must be at minimum 8. Sebab 8, kita naik kat atas ni 8. So, sebelah ni kita tak tahu berapa. So, when you do not know what is K, so you can read over here. Okay, more than 8, less than 6. Okay, E must be more than 8. Sebab kat sini ada 8. So, 8 naik kat atas. Sebab 8 ni merupakan max. Right? Tapi kita tak tahu kat sini jawapan ni apa. Tapi apa-apa pun E ni lebih daripada 8. So you can see that this number does not overlap. The number, this number can only be from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this number start with 8. So 6 and 8 does not overlap with each other. So you can prune K. Okay, kita tengok number di K ni tak kisah number apa pun kita boleh padam. Sebab kalau K ni number dia 100 pun dia takkan naik kepada B. Dia takkan jejaskan jawapan di B. Okay, let's test your theory. So let's say that we have the number here 6, 5, 8, 100. So 6 and 5, you get 6. 8 and 100, you get 100. But the final answer will still be 6 over here. Sebab 100 duduk naik ke atas, tapi kat sini bahagian minimum. So you get minimum. So this is the minimum turn. Okay, mean. Okay, merah ni mean. So tetap 6. Okay, let's say that if you put 0 here at K. So 8 akan naik. Mean ni tetap juga jawapan ni 6. Okay, 6. Right, now we know that B has B is already 6. So the final answer here would be more than 6. Okay, max would be more than 6. But 6, atas ni mesti dah lebih daripada 6. Okay, here we have 2 and 1. So max 2 and 1, you have 2. And then mean. Okay, mean. Okay, would be less than 2. Okay, mean will be less than 2. So, now you have more than 6, less than 2. So, more than 6, number ni maksudnya dia tak akan overlap dengan 2. Okay, the number won't overlap. So, you have 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here you have 2, 1, 0, negative 1, negative 2. So, when these two numbers do not overlap, you can prune G. Okay? Okay. Sebab kita tak perlu tahu apa number yang ada dekat sini. Kat bawah G ni. Kita tak perlu tahu pun. Bawah K ni kita tak perlu tahu. So, this is what we call it as alpha, beta pruning. Alright. Which is alpha, which is beta? So, beta cut off happen when it is below mean. Okay, kalau bawah mean, dia panggil beta. Kalau bawah max, kita panggil alpha. Alpha cut off. Okay, that is the only rule that you should remember. Alright. Next, we look into another slide. Alright, you can look here on this slide. Okay, to this slide, play automatically. So, press F5 and relax. So, I've created this slide just for you. So, if you do not understand about minimax, let's look into this slide. Right? So, the question discussed here is based on page 432 in your note. Okay. How to do this question? Left to right minimizing. So, you have here 3, 8 and 3, 12 and 8. So, you can block this. Okay? Because you can block this area. Right? So, now you have 12 at the birth. Because this is would be max turn. And then, on the mean turn, you know that the maximum number here must be less than 12. Okay? Must be less or equal than 12. So, here 3. You know over here, these two numbers must be more than 3. So, here you have overlapping numbers. Okay, more than 3, less than 12 is overlapping. So, then if it's overlapping, you have to look into the next node. So, kita tak boleh prune. When it's overlapping, you have to look at the next node. So, 4, more than 4 and less than 12. It is also overlapping. Right? Overlapping. So, you cannot prune this node. So, we have no choice and we have to go to the next node. So, number 9 and 6 goes up because it is a max turn. 3, 4, 6, 6. Okay, next, you look at the next node. So, next node, you know that the above would be 6. Okay, macam mana jawapan ni? Jawapan ni adalah 6 ataupun kurang. Alright, tapi sini kita ada 14. We have 14. So, 14, when you go up here, it must be more than 14. So, less than 6, more than 14 would be what we can say would be non-overlapping. Eh? It can be non-overlapping. So what is the concept of overlapping and non-overlapping? So overlapping ni maksudnya nombor ni dia bertindih. Dia bertindih lah 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sampai 14 dia bertindih. But this one is not overlap. Okay, sebab nombor ni kurang daripada 6. Nombor ni lebih daripada 14. So lebih daripada 14 mesti nombor dia start daripada 14. 14, 15, 16, 17 and to the infinity. While here you have 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and lower than that. So because this number won't overlap with each other, dia takkan ada pertindihan. So these two nodes can be pruned. Okay, non-overlap. So we can prune these two numbers. So don't worry, we will do this again on another segment. So we will see this again on another segment on practice make perfect on how to answer minimax question. So stay tuned. Okay, again, we will try to explore this question from the book. So here we have a question regarding minimax 3. Apply left to right alpha beta pruning with minimizing. So from what we have learned before, minimizing means at the top we start with min. And then max. So the differences is that for this time, we will try to do alpha beta pruning. Like okay, left to right alpha beta pruning. The meaning of left to right is you have to read the tree from the left first. Alright, in order to do this, I have a few tips for you. You can use your hand, okay, your hand over here. And then cover part of the note. So that you don't know the answer to the note. Or if you are on a digital computer, you can cover this with this block. Okay, this block. Right, in order to do alpha beta pruning, okay, the first note at the top over here must be evaluated first. Right, max. So what is the maximum number over here? 3, 12, 8. So the max would be 12. Right, I try to format the picture. Right. So, automatically we know that at the top of the branch over there, the number must be less than 12. Okay, the number must be less or equal than 12. Sebab minimum kan? Minimum maksudnya mesti the nombor ni kurang daripada 12. So, less than equal than 12. Okay, next, we try to move the number, right? So, max, okay? Max over here. So, max would be, whatever the max is that, this must be more equals 2, right? More or equals 2. Right, okay, because more than equal 2 and less than equal 12 overlap with each other. So, apa yang dikatakan overlap ni, maksudnya nombor daripada 2 ni, dia boleh naik ke atas. Okay, the number 2 here can go up in front. Right, because it overlap. So, 12 ke bawah, 2 ke ke atas kan. Above 2, below 12, it represent the same set of number. Okay, 2, 3, 4, 5, up until 12. Here 12, down up until 2, up until negative infinity here, up until 12, up until positive infinity. Okay, next. Okay, we try to look at number 4. So, bila 4 ni lebih tinggi, max, 4 ni naik atas. So, adakah 4 ni overlap? So, if the number 4 overlap with 12, so it overlap. So, you cannot prune here. So automatically you have to open the node up until here. So this will become 6. Confirm. Okay, 6. Okay, sebab kita dah tak ada dah more than 6. Okay, confirm dah kata max ni adalah 6. So then we can update over here. So less than 12. So minimum antara 12 dengan 6 apa yang paling minimum? 6 kan? Okay, 6. So, on top of here, the number must be less than 6. Right? Less than 6. The number over here must be less than 6. Okay, here. Okay? Okay, on this note, the number must be less than 6. Kalau less than 6, baru dia boleh naik ke atas. Right? Here we have 14. So, max 14 maksudnya 14 dan ke atas lah. Nilai dia mestilah minimum 14. So, 14 and above. So, what will happen here is that we have to compare the number. Okay? 6 and 14. So, is the number, set of the number overlap with each other? So, the answer would be not overlap. Okay, dia takkan overlap. Dua number ni takkan overlap. Because 6 ke bawah, bawah berdena dia takkan jumpa 14. 14 pula ke atas. 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Okay, 20, 21, up until infinity. It won't find 6 above. So, with that information, we know that we don't have to know about the number. So, number ni kita letaklah berapa ribu pun, berapa ratus pun. Dia takkan boleh naik ke atas ataupun dia takkan jejaskan jawapan ni di atas ni. Dan itu kurang daripada 6. So, nombor apa yang kurang ataupun sama dengan 6 kat sini? 6. So, kamu boleh cuba letaklah apa-apa nombor pun kat sini. Jawapan dia tetap 6. Alright, you can try it. Okay, it's like a magic. But it is actually mathematic. It's actually mathematic using minimax. Right, kamu cuba letak dua apa pun nombor kat sini. Gantilah nombor 5 dengan 2 ni jadi 100 ke, satu lagi jadi kosong ke, jadi negatif 1000 ke, dua-dua nombor ni. Tak kisah. Jawapan akhir sekali mestilah 6. Okay, that's why we can prune this this number. So next segment, we will look into maximizing. Alright, we look into maximizing. So in left to right maximizing, we start with max. Okay, over here, you start with max. And then the next level would become min. Alright. Okay, let's see how you do this. Okay, remember, if you are still learning, you can use this block to block it out, to block the number out in order to do pruning. Okay, you can use your hand or you can block it out using the shapes. The 3, 8 and 12, which are the minimum? Okay, the minimum value would be 3. Okay, then now we know at the top the maximum value must be starting with 3. Okay, max dia mesti dah lebih besar daripada 3. Right? Antara tiga-tiga note ni, dua yang kita tak tahu, two unknown. We now know that the final note must be more and equal than 3. Kita boleh agak sebab sini 3. Maksudnya atas ni mesti menang lebih daripada 3 lah. Baru dia akan menang. Okay? Dua ni mesti lebih daripada 3. Dua note ni. Kalau dua ni tak bukan lebih daripada 3, maka 3 menang. Jawapan ni 3 lah. Tapi yang confirm, nombor ni mesti lebih daripada 3. Okay, we try to move this a little bit. Okay, now 2. Okay, 2 minimum. So, okay, what should we write here? Okay, minimum 2. So, we know that apa-apa pun note kat sini, mestilah paling besar 2. Okay, must be 2 or less. Because sebab ini minimum. Maknanya 2 sama 2. Tak pun 2 note ni kena kurang daripada 2. Must be less than 2. Alright, now we evaluate. Okay, between max and min. So, this is more than 3. This is less than 3. So, the real question is that if the set overlap, okay, if the value overlap, so the answer is no. Okay, cause 2 ni dia akan ada 2, 1, 0, negative 1, negative 2 and below. This one max, dia akan pilih 3. Antara 3 dengan kurang daripada 2, dia akan pilih 3 lah. So 3 ni dia takkan overlap dengan 2. So this one 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 and above. So we now know that we do not care about this number. So this number will become mystery to us. And we do not know, we do not have to know about this number. Okay, tak payah tahu pun pasal nombor ni. So why? Because whatever value inside this node, jawapan atas dia tetap 3 ke atas. Tetap nombor 3 ke atas. So doesn't care. It won't. The number would not carry pass over this node. Macam mana pun 2 ni akan menang. Okay. Apa-apa nombor ni 2 ni akan menang. Ataupun kalau 2 ni kalah, nombor atas ni tetap atas daripada 3. So dia takkan carry forward ke atas. So this is minimax. Right. So sekarang kita nak nombor ni jadi misteri. So kita tutup lah. Kita tak kisah. So kita tutup. Alright. So kita tutup ni. So tadi dah nampak. Alright. Kita buka kat sini. Okay. 14. Minimum. Okay. Minimum 14. So what will be written here? Maksudnya number ni mesti less than 14. Right. Minimum. 14 or below. Right. We have to compare. More than 3, less than 14. So, this number overlap with each other. Okay? The set overlap. So, we cannot cancel both of these. We cannot prune both of these. So, we have to pull it back. Okay, now 5. 5, 14 and 5, minimum value would be 5. So, less than 5. So, less than 5, more than 3, would overlap also. Alright? Would overlap. So, you cannot cancel or you cannot prune this. Table. Okay, you cannot prune this 3. So, kita kena tarik sini lah. Tarik sini jadi 2. So, ini value dia confirm 2. So, jawapannya kita tahu last kali mesti lebih ataupun sama dengan 3. So, final answer would be 2, 2, kurang daripada 2, 3. So, jawapannya adalah 3 lah. So, ini kita prune. Kita tak perlu tahu pun note ni apa dia yang bawah ni. Sebab jawapannya mesti 3. Letaklah apa-apa value kat sini yang saya tutup ni. Jawapan 3. Okay. Dalam buku, dia letak 4 dengan 6. Right? 4 dengan 6. Tapi kita letak 4, 6. Jawapan 3. Kamu letak kosong, kosong. Jawapan 3. 5,000, 5,000. Jawapan dia 3. Negatif sejuta. Negatif sejuta pun jawapan dia 3 juga. Kat atas. So, that's why we can prune this 3. So, this is the magic of... Minimax. So where this is where the magic happens on the minimax tree. So the question about minimax will be covered in the final test and final assessment. So we can look on the final examination paper past year for sample question of minimax. So that's all for our lecture for minimax on alpha beta pruning. Oh yeah, before I forget, sometimes you need to label whether this is alpha or beta pruning. So yang ni kita panggil beta pruning. So you have to remember back on the lecture. So dalam lecture slide, bawah min kita akan panggil beta, bawah max. Kalau pruning ni happen bawah max, kita akan panggil alpha. So this pruning happen under max. So, we call it beta. Okay, beta pruning. The alpha is under max. So, this one under mean become beta pruning. Alright, that's all for our lecture. If you have any question, you can ask me. Carry marks will be available to you at the soonest. And our test will be set after 10. Okay, after 10th of July. So that's all I can say to you. See you again afterwards. Okay, with the final chapter that is on fuzzy logic.